Hey, what's up everyone, it's your girl Brandi Shanae, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my July TBR, so please stay tuned. Every single day, I'm going to make something great, that's my way. Every single day, I'm going to make. And we're back. So as regarding my July TBR, I'm thinking about only reading 4 books due to the fact that my due date is July the 30th, and I don't want to, I know for that whenever I give birth I'm gonna be tired and I'm probably not gonna be reading anything, but I might, who knows. But so I think I might stick to just 4 books this month just to be on the safe side so I can accomplish that. So the first book that I'll be reading is The Rage of Dragons by Evan Winter. This is the first book and his debut book. I kept seeing a lot of this around BookTube and I heard a lot of great things about it. I know the second book comes out I think in September this year, I'm not really certain, but I wanted to get my hands on this and read it. It states, a world caught in eternal war, one young man will become his people's only hope for survival. It says Game of Thrones meets Gladiator and Evan Winter's The Rage of Dragons, a novel that started as a self-publishing sensation and has become one of the most acclaimed epic fantasy debuts of recent years. So already it sounds great and I'm looking forward to reading it. And so, like I said, like this book, like when it said Game of Thrones meets Gladiator, I'm like, okay, I'm all for that. I love Game of Thrones, so I feel like I will definitely love this and everything about dragons and and I love Gladiator too with Russell Crowe in it. So yeah, so this is one of the books that I'll be reading in July. The next book that I'll be reading, which I definitely need to read because everyone else has and I need to get on this, that is A Song of Wraiths and Ruin by Roseanne Brown. I had gotten this signed by her and everything, so I was able to get her signature. I wanted to read this because I was trying to read this in June but didn't get a hold of it like I wanted to, so I had to pretty much revamp my TBR in June. So I'm definitely going to be reading this in July. And it says, for Malik, the Solstacia Festival is a chance to escape his war-stricken home and start a new life with his sisters in the prosperous desert city of Zyron. But when a vengeful spirit abducts Malik's younger sister, Nadia, as payment to enter the city, Malik strikes a fatal deal. Kill Karina, Crown Princess of Zyron, in exchange for Nadia's freedom. But Karina has deadly aspirations of her own. Her mother, the Sultana, has been assassinated. Her court threatens mutiny and Solstacia looms like a knife over her neck. Grief-stricken, Karina decides to resurrect her mother through ancient magic, requiring the beating heart of a king. And she knows just how to obtain one, by offering her hand in marriage to the victor of the Solstacia's competition. When Malik rigs his way into the contest, he and Karina are set on a heart-pounding course to destroy each other. But as attraction flares between them and ancient evils stir, will they be able to see their task to the death? So already I'm all for this book and cannot wait to get a hold of that. So this is the second book I'll be reading in July. Next book that comes out, I believe, July the 7th, is a book that I've been anticipating, and that is A Cinderella Is Dead by Kaylin Barron. So I'll definitely be reading that in July as well. And the description says, it's 200 years after Cinderella found her prince. But the fairy tale is over. Teen girls are now required to appear at the annual ball where the men of the kingdom select wives based on a girl's display of finery. If a suitable match is not found, the girls not chosen are never heard from again. 16-year-old Sophia would much rather marry Aaron, her childhood best friend, than parade in front of suitors. At the ball, Sophia makes the desperate decision to flee and finds herself hiding in Cinderella's mausoleum. There she meets Constance, the last known descendant of Cinderella and her stepsisters. Together they vow to bring down the king once and for all, and in the process they learn that there's more to Cinderella's story than they ever knew. This fresh take on a classic story will make readers question the tales they've been told and root for girls to break down the constructs of the world around them. So I'm definitely looking forward to reading that. I have pre-ordered the book, so definitely can't wait to get that in the mail. I think when I get in the mail, it'll come out. I'll receive it the day it comes out, which is July the 7th. So today's July the 1st. So yeah, I definitely am anticipating on getting that so I can start reading that as soon as possible. So I'm going to strategize. I might read multiple books at once, just because I really don't do that a lot, but I just might do that this month just to make sure I get my reading done before I have my baby. But yeah, so, and then the fourth book I'm debating about, I'm thinking about reading it, real, cause I've been hearing a lot of great things about it, and it's an adult fantasy book. And I ordered it because I was like, maybe I should read this. I kept hearing great things about it. And that is The City of Brass by S.A. Chakraborty. About that. I read the description of it and I loved it. And it says, Nahiri has never believed in magic. Certainly she has power. On the streets of 18th century Cairo, she's a con woman of unsurpassed talent, but she knows better than anyone that the trade she uses to get by, palm readings, czars, healings are all tricks, sleights of hand, learned skills, a means to the delightful end of swindling Ottoman nobles. But when Nahiri accidentally summons an equally sly, darkly mysterious Dinj warrior to her side during one of her cons, she's forced to accept that the magical world she thought only existed in childhood stories is real. For the warrior tells her a new tale. Across hot, wide-swept sands, teeming with creatures of fire and rivers where the mythical merits sleep, past ruins of once magnificent human metropolises and mountains, while the circling hawks are not what they seem, lies Zevabad, the legendary city of brass, a city to which Nahiri is irrevocably bound. In that city, behind gilded brass walls laced with enchantments, behind the six gates of the six Dinj tribes, all old resentments are simmering. And when Nahiri decides to enter this world, she learns that true power is fierce and brutal. That magic cannot shield her from the dangerous web of court politics. Not even the cleverest of schemes can have deadly consequences. After all, there is a reason they say, be careful what you wish for. So I'm thinking about reading that as my fourth book, but who knows, I might change it up because I know that is a long book as well. But we'll see. But there you have it, guys. That is my July TBR. I hope you enjoyed this little video of mine. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Also hit the subscribe button and that bell to be notified when I upload more videos in the future. But thank you so much, you guys. See ya.